Let's take our time and watch this video that I want to show here. Watch this video.
Hi everyone. So I've been reading in different blogs in the last 24 hours of how Wigwe's daughter gave a handshake to the vice president of Nigeria sitting down, and people have been saying so many nasty things about the young lady, how she's disrespectful, how other people were standing up to greet the same person. She should have stood up to greet the man. She lacks home training, blah 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 blah. As usual, Nigerians pulling her down for giving a handshake to a guest, to her father, her mother and her brother's Service of Songs event. So the question I'm posing to all of you people who are opening your mouth to blab rubbish about that lady, I don't know that lady anyway, but just reading stuff about her like that is so heartbreaking. That young lady has just lost three family members at once. Three family members at once. She lost her mom, her dad, and her brother in a plane crash. She's not going to see them ever again. Helicopter crash. Yeah. She's not going to see them ever again. They're not even going to be buried wholly. They're only going to pick up pieces of their body parts, if there is any, or probably a burnt part of their body, or probably even their ashes. That's where they're going to bury. Do you people, those of you Nigerians especially, because you guys have so much big deal about respect, like you guys cry and shout about respect so much that you think respect is some kind of equity or some kind of investment that you have to get return on in the long run. I don't get it. Do you guys know how messed up that girl is mentally? I lost my sister 2 weeks ago, one family member, and for days I could not function. For days, I could not think straight. For days, my entire body was reacting to the news because it was a sudden death, and I was shocked from the top of my head to the bottom of my feet. I could not even feel anything because I lost one family member. I lost a sibling, okay? So this is someone who's lost three family members at once, suddenly. And you guys are slagging her off because she did not stand up to greet your vice president? Like, seriously? Do you know how messed up she is mentally? Yeah, she was there physically. Do you think she was there mentally? Some Nigerians, man. I don't get you guys at all. I don't.
Yes. Listening to this lady, I can not but agree with her. This is the picture that was trending. The vice president, Shettima, came to Service of Songs of late Herbert Wigwe, former CEO of Access Bank. And then the daughter, the bereaved daughter, didn't stand up to greet Shettima, the vice president of Nigeria. Rather, she sat down to greet him. And people started taking pictures, sharing the picture that she couldn't, she lacked respect, she don't have respect. How could she sit down to greet the vice president? Come on! This lady just lost her father, her mother, and her brother in a day. In a day. Burial in a day. Look at the picture of the burial. If you look at the video, the burial had been done today, Saturday. And you have the nerve to criticize someone that, come on now. I agree with this lady that you just watched. I want you to go back and listen to her again. Listen to her again from beginning. You could understand why it's not good to criticize someone that is bereaving. If you have lost someone in your family before, you will know how painful it is, especially during the event, the day of the time of the event. you will see that your brain will not function very well because you'll be thinking about this person. And this is not just a person that died in this girl's family, but three notable persons died. Parents. Losing your parents at once. Having the burial of your parents at once. Men, some Nigerians need to sit up. Everything is not cruise online. Everything is not chasing of clout. You know, everything is not just for clout chasing. It's not respect. We keep saying respect, respect, respect in everything. I don't have anything to say, but the only thing I will say is that before you criticize someone, put yourself in the shoe of that person. Before you criticize me, put yourself in my shoes. Before you criticize me, then after putting yourself in my shoes, you can criticize me if you want. You know, thank you for watching this video. Please do well to click on subscribe and share this video. People need to learn that it's not everything we criticize. Bye.